Pretty straightforward, two chances each. Hardest shot, highest speed on the radar gun wins. Al Iafredi did it with a wooden stick. That white Sherwood that Al MacInnis used was a pretty good weapon in his hands. And now the technology is in favor of the shooters. John Klingberg is the leading scorer in the National Hockey League among defensemen. He's on pace for 60 points this season. I don't know that he's known around the league for his shot, but his teammates say it's pretty darn good.
Yeah, they do, and we'll find out here. Amazingly, in 22 years of competition in this, there's only been 8 winners. So that tells you just how often one player dominates. Chara 5 times, MacInnis 7 times, and Weber the last hat trick, the last 3 in a row.
Hey, I'm going to throw a crazy idea out.
Okay.
Bring Chara back just for this.
Why not?
Bring MacInnis back for this. Bring Al Iafredi back for this. Why not?
A little competition.
Yes,
for sure.
Bring Mike Gardner back with Larkin, and let's see who wins that.
Al said the other day, he said, if I could turn back the clock to when I was 25 and use the new technology, I could shoot a lot harder than I did back in the 90s. There's the first shot for John Klingberg. He's at 96-6. It's interesting that this hardest shot is now a slap shot in this competition, yet the slap shot is one of the least used shots in the game right now. John scored 3 times this season with a slap shot. Ovi leads the league with 11 goals from a slap shot, usually a one-timer slap shot. And isn't it amazing that he's never won this competition?
Yeah, I just can't quite get it over that 100 mark. And you know, there's a lot of debate whether do you put it along the ice, do you put it a foot off. If you go too high, I think often it gets a little bit slower. And he's looking up on that one, wondering, okay, I'm going to maybe do better my next time.
PK Subban is going to be the third shooter, and down on the bench and at ice level joining us for this competition is Mike Smith. What's tougher, playing goal or looking after all those boys?
Oh, man, it's pretty close.
Do you find that goaltending technology has kept up with the shooter's technology?
They keep trying to take our gear away, to be honest.
They never do that with the sticks, though.
No, I know. They keep making the sticks better, but they're taking more gear away. That's okay. It's all good.
We were just talking about how the slap shot is a disappearing shot in the game. The reasons for it? Too many players in front of the net?
Yeah, I think just the time it takes to get it off now. I think guys are blocking more shots now with the new game, and I think every team seems like they're getting in lanes and stuff, so I think the quicker you can get it to the net now, it seems like it's a better option for you.
You've seen that shot a few times.
Look at that muffin.
One of the things about these types of games is a lot of ribbon goes on, doesn't it?
Shot his number.
He did.
Hey, nice marshmallow gun.
And here's the local favorite, Steven Stamkos. He had a laser beam of a one-timer. He's had a few of them this season, but the other night in Nashville. Here's his slap shot from a skating start, and he gets it to 95-2.
Man, I think this gun's skewed.
You know, you always wonder that, don't you? It's temperamental little thing. He tried to get a couple of quick strides and hit behind that puck, took a little bit too much off it.
Mike, toughest shot for you. Who's the player in the league when it goes to the rafters, you go, oh, please don't hit me?
Well, I think the new guy now is Laine in Winnipeg. Obviously, he's a heck of a player, but you know, for a long time it's been Ovechkin. Just the deceptiveness he has with this puck, how he holds it back and uses a whip of the stick, it's real hard shot to read.
So through this second round, with just 5 shooters in this competition, they'll go slowest to fastest, and Brent Burns gets up to 92-4 for his second shot. What do you make of this new shot in the game that a lot of guys are using now, that off-speed shot where they're not worried about rifling it into the net, just picking a spot?
I hate it, to be honest. But I think those are the hardest shots to save as a goalie, are the ones that they look like they're coming in hard, and then all of a sudden they either change direction or don't go where the shooter wants to shoot it. So,
and you've got a teammate who's one of the best at it, Matthew Tkachuk. Does he do it in practice?
All the time.
You're a veteran. You should make that eliminate that.
No, exactly. No, he's a good kid. He uses it well. He's a smart player, and he's got rewarded for it.
Now, Mike, you played in Tampa from 08 to 11, any great memories here? Because you got a great ovation when you were announced.
You know what? I really enjoyed my time here. There's such good people in this organization that are still here to this day. Obviously, Stamkos and Hedman are the only two players that are still here. But some of my fondest memories are playing in Tampa here. Really enjoyed fishing in the outdoors and got to do that quite a bit when I was here. So obviously, the time spent here was awesome.
Mike, tell us about your adjustment. In Calgary, I'm sure it's a little bit of a change going back to a Canadian team and having to get off to a good start. How's your adjustment been there?
It's been pretty seamless, to be honest. It's been rejuvenating. At this point in my career, when you get older, you realize that your chances of winning are diminishing before your eyes. So I think to go to a team like Calgary that has expectations to win now has been a breath of fresh air for me.
One more shot, and Ovi has already captured his first ever hardest shot competition, because his first shot at 98.8 is the hardest one so far. So he gets another crack to see if he can get to 100, and he does.
The showman.
Alexander Ovechkin, the winner of the hardest shot competition. Mike, did you get your kids out to this Gasparilla today? Did they all get dressed up as pirates?
They did not. They're always pirates, guys. Yeah. They're always pirates.
Hooligans of the first order. Mike, thanks a lot for stopping by.
Thanks for having me, guys. Take care.
And downstairs, here's David.
All right. The great eight was the great 98.8 until that final shot. You broke 100. You said that was your goal, Alex.
Yeah, I tell the boys, I was a little nervous before that, before the game, so happy to get the win. It's nice.
It seems unfair, though. So many of your 500-plus goals have come on those one-timers. You've had a lot more practice than some of these guys.
Yeah, sometimes it's just one-timers from the past. Never felt like I'm going to have that kind of shot from the standing.
Well, you're a showman, and you got things done tonight. Congratulations, Alex.
Yeah, thank you.
13 straight. 30-goal seasons, many of the goals scored on a shot just like that, 101.3 miles an hour.